بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله. Welcome to Spirit of Islam. I am your host Ashraf Zaglul. And today inshallah we'll talk about entrepreneurs and encouraging young people to go into business. When I was young, I heard Hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet saying that 9/10 of all rizq, and rizq is what God provides to humans, goes to business people. And I do the math and I say, how many business people are? 1% of the humans or 0.5%? And yet they go, 9/10 of the risk goes to them. So it puzzled me till, you know, I went into business myself and I realized being in business, you realize that the risk of the providing is from Allah. In a job, you expect your salary, fixed salary, whatever it is, 3,000, 5,000 a month. And you don't realize that things happen from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we think it's our work that does it. However, so today I'd like to introduce my guests, Sami Ahmed, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Zulfiqar Haider.
Wa alaikum assalam.
And Suhail Ahmed, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Zulfiqar, we'll start with you. What's your feeling about entrepreneurs and how do you encourage young people to become entrepreneurs?
I think in order to understand entrepreneurship, you need to first understand who the entrepreneurs are. Entrepreneurs are people who really conceive an idea and make and develop it, gather all the resources together and make it successful. In order to make a business successful, it could be a small enterprise, it could be very large enterprise, and it doesn't necessarily need to be a person who's self-employed.
But the question first comes to the mind, are you born with it or is that a skill that you develop?
I really feel that that skill can be developed, although some people are born entrepreneurs, they can actually go and start doing business like Steve Jobs, but I feel you can develop.
I don't know if you're born with it or the environment around you really helps you. You know, you find the environment, whether your parents have a business or, you know, your family business, this kind of thing. What's your feeling, Sam?
I believe there are some individuals with an innate ability to become really strong leaders.
Yeah.
However, there are individuals who, because of the circumstance of their environment, whether their parents or their friends or their coworkers were entrepreneurs, they have the ability to learn from their experiences. And as a positive consequence, they can become entrepreneurs themselves.
Good. Suhail, what's your experience in this?
Well, Brother Ashraf, I would basically tend to disagree somewhat with Zulfiqar. Because from my own experience, for example, my father was not a businessman.
Yeah.
Right. He was a professor and educator. And I believe a lot of entrepreneurs are born with it. I would say 75% are born with it. And that is why
You're not giving a lot of hope for those who are not born with it, huh?
Not necessarily. They can develop the skills. Mm-hmm. But again, entrepreneurs lack certain abilities, such as good entrepreneurs, powerful entrepreneurs, are often poor managers.
Okay.
Whereas managers are good at managing, they have that skill set which can be developed, but they're often not as good as evaluating. But
let's
risks.
Start look at the organization life cycle. Yeah. When you're building, you don't need the management, you need that spirit, the hard work. Okay. And then once it's established, you need to manage it well. So it goes, I feel organization goes through life cycles. And when, you know, management comes later.
Yeah, I tend to agree a little bit on you, with you, but I really feel that if we just say that businessmen are people who are born with it, it might not be the right concept. I really feel that people who have gone to universities developed their management abilities, their, you know, interpersonal relationship, the way they actually work with it, their business acumen are very successful, whether they are successful managers or whether they
are. And you know, you use the word born with it. What is this it? This it is the fire inside to achieve.
Yeah. Yes.
You know, and are you really born with the fire or it's you have that passion for something?
Well, I think, you know, I agree with Zulfiqar that you can develop into it. And again, not all business people are entrepreneurs. When you take over an existing business, or you're just, you know, carrying over something. True entrepreneurship is when you're actually creating something. You're building something, which is an idea, into reality. Mm-hmm. And that is, not all businesses do that. So
let me clarify. Let's say somebody hires me to run a business. They have their own business and they say, Zulfikar, you have this experience. They bring me in to develop that business. Are they hiring me as an entrepreneur or as a manager?
As a manager, probably.
But with my entrepreneur skills, if they were lacking, they will never hire me.
I don't know if you ever really hire an entrepreneur. An entrepreneur has an idea and he goes and starts it himself. That's my feeling.
And we cannot be hired. Like, you're an entrepreneur. I'm an entrepreneur.
It's difficult to hire an entrepreneur. I don't like to be owned.
So how could you hire him?
I think key businessmen would tend to not be hired. But there are so many businesses which are actually run by entrepreneurs who are actually employees of the company. They tend to be employees. The shareholders might be the owners. Shareholders don't really run the business. Right. It's the business managers who do.
Well, let's go to another line. You say somebody has passion for something. He has this great idea and he feels only if he's given a chance he can conquer the world or make it very successful. It's the best thing after sliced bread. Everybody has the best idea. What do you say to them? How do they go about it? What's your thoughts, Sam?
I think they need to assess their current situation and they have to be able to be ready to take a risk, a calculated risk. Can I make the leap from, let's say, a full-time job or from school into entrepreneurship? And what's the payoff in that? And there can be a great payoff.
But that's the question. I don't know if you can do a calculated risk and be an entrepreneur. You know, a lot of entrepreneurs have put their life saving, everything in it, because he really believes in it. And that what makes it happen is that belief in it. But if you hesitate, you lose. I don't know.
I think if you want to make a business successful, you need that fire within you to make it succeed. Mm-hmm. But you also need good business planning. And one of the things that we normally do is teach new entrepreneurs exactly what type of plan they should put in place, what kind of people they should have.
So where could they find this resources, somebody to help them business planning? Because honestly, you go to somebody and they want to charge you a lot of money. To start with, you don't have the money, or the money you have, you want to pour into your idea rather than, you know, this. So what advice do we have? How do we tell a young person, here is a business plan?
I really don't think you need to pay a lot for getting these advisors. And, you know, we can, as an association, help people. Also, we'll talk about it a bit later as well.
Well, tell us about the association now and how we can help young people.
One service that is out there is the Crescent Entrepreneur Association, otherwise known as CEA. And they have the vision of becoming the largest network of Muslim entrepreneurs in Canada.
Yes.
So essentially, they're an incubator of new business ideas. Mm-hmm. And they offer services to existing business owners and new business owners who are just starting up with free services through a link to affiliates who can offer them free advice, free services. Mm-hmm. And target market that we have is the youth as well as the professionals.
Yes.
So we want to really start at a young age, inspire that spirit of entrepreneurship, have them understand that it is doable and it is a viable career option for them.
How do we explain to young people it should not be about money? If it's just about money from start, it can never succeed.
You've seen that picture. Greed is good, right?
Like, to be honest, a true entrepreneur, we wake up in the morning not for the money. Mm-hmm. If you're waking up in the morning, or if you're starting this out for the money, then you will not really be able to achieve as much as if you're trying to change something, or you're trying to create either a better mousetrap, or you're trying to deliver something that is not in the market.
Yes.
And that is the passion. You want to get your product out there.
You know, for every successful business, you need to have a clear objective in mind. You should know exactly what you're doing. If that passion which is driving it is to come up with a product which is very successful, you're really passionate about it, you'll succeed.
And maybe the important thing is we should not say money is the objective. Money is a long-term objective that's an end result. I remember, you know, a friend of mine telling me, a wise friend saying, do what you enjoy doing and do what you like doing, and money will come. You know what I mean? So rather than say somebody else is successful in this field, I'll follow them, do what your hearts and what you believe in, and work hard, believe in it, and inshallah money will come.